guys. I'm just gonna go see him and then I'll come back and tell you. He'll be all right.
He's dead, isn't he?
In New York, representatives to the United Nations met today in a rare closed-door session as fears continue to mount over the recent outbreak of avian flu in China. Speculation that the virus has now become transmissible from human to human has reached a fevered pitch around the globe. Callie Ferland is live from Hong Kong.
He was fine. He just had a little cough, that's all. What's wrong with him?
I'm not currently at liberty to discuss
this. He's my husband. I need to be with him.
Of course. She'll take you.
I need to speak with Secretary Reed at Cyrus Barnack. What could you please find him? Yes, it's an emergency. Secretary Reed, it's Iris Barnack. I'm sorry to call so late. Yes, we've confirmed it is the H5N1. And the patient lives in Richmond, but he's just returned from the Guangdong province. There's no telling how many people he's been in contact with. Well, whether or not Ed Conley is our patient zero here in America, I mean, you can just bet that he's one of many we'll see in the next few days. To beat the press and address the nation, he needs to do it quickly. The avian flu is in America.
His SQ waves up. Cute MI.
He's coding. Let's start compression.
ECU 2 up to 7.
Push some EPI here.
Tell you is what the president said last night. The avian flu is here. We're doing everything possible to ensure that
we're
educating medical personnel around the country about the flu to ensure the highest levels have detailed plans about the isolation of infected patients. Developing a vaccine is our highest priority.
What kind of precautions?
Should we be closing schools?
What about churches and malls and all the other places where people
gather?
Look,
this administration believes that those decisions are best left to the respective states.
Still a lot of
debate about whether or not masks are an effective means of keeping the virus from spreading. Washing your hands thoroughly. Now, those are the kinds of common sense precautions everybody should be taking. I want to reiterate, there's absolutely no need for panic.
The pneumonia on the lungs causes the acute respiratory distress syndrome. Not all patients with H5 get ARDS. For those that do, at least 40 to 60% of them will die. An hour prior to his death, he complained of body aches so intense he thought his bones were breaking. Coughed so violently that he tore apart his abdominal muscles and his rib cartilage. Basically, he drowned in his own blood.
Thank you.
than last week.
We got more Tamiflu, but only 300 doses.
Well, they're all going to be screaming at us again?
There isn't any us, hon. I'm off in 15 minutes.
You can't just stay a little longer?
I can't. He calls my kids preschool. I got to pick him up before my neighbor leaves for a night shift.
What am I going to tell all these people here?
You'll figure something out, or they'll eat you alive.
Hi, Judy. Why are so many people dying while others seem fine?
That's an important question, Richard. Not everyone who is exposed to the virus will get sick. Now, we think that factors like age and genetics and your immune system do play a part.
Hey, Sandra.
Are you at the Connolly neighborhood?
Yeah, I just got here.
Is it as bad as we heard?
It's even worse. I'm on my way to see Governor Newsom now. Provided they let me into the Fortress of Solitude. I'll call you back.
Dr. Varnak, sorry to keep you waiting. What can I do for you?
Did
you flip that switch?
There you go.
Governor Newsom, it's quite a setup you've created for you and your staff here.
As biosecure as we can make it. We even have a recirculating air filtration system. From here, I have contact with every governmental department in Virginia and D.C. My job is to protect the people of this state. The best way I know how to do that is to ensure continuity of leadership. Now, is there something you needed?
Yes, the director of the CDC asked me to come see you. You've instituted quarantines in several neighborhoods around the state.
That's right. A couple of housing projects, a military base, and the neighborhood where that